after the season of 2011, it was not promising at all. We had only Arshad Jamaldeen, Adil Jabba, myself, Taraka and Yasin as the colorsmen. So we got together and we sorted out the problems right then and there. We told Theo Seraphim and Asang Rodrigo what we needed to do, and we planned the practice sessions. We started off with house games, so we could identify a couple of sprinters and, like, you know, jumpers from that who were coming after the sports meet. After that, we started practices, and eventually we identified what game plan we wanted to play and, like, you know, what potential we have in our team, passing skills. We identify all that, and we established a game plan. And talking about that, I think that's where the 2011 team stands out, because we didn't have much potential, but we worked as a team, and a lot of players put out their heart and like, you know, showed attitude at practices, coming into every session, showing that they wanted to play, they wanted to be a part of this team, rather than, like, you know, trying to be individuals. The team that played for under 18 last year, they had a lot of senior players who could straight away join for the first 15 squad, so the squad was big. But we had a lot of young players. That's where Theo Seraphim, Asang Rodrigo, they came in and, like, you know, they helped a lot of players to identify their potential and what they can do during the season. So I think that's where the wonder happened, and that's how we clinched the title that year. Should be honest and straight with you. A few players who stood up was Dilip, Andrew Srivadana, Vaseem Bawa, Ijaz Buran. Actually, it was their first season, but they showed a lot of potential and a lot of attitude coming for practices and during the games as well. Coming into the first match, it was quite a task for me to lead a lot of young players into the field. But I expected more of them, and they actually lived up to my expectations. On the first game as well, we beat St. Joseph's in our home grounds. We got a comfortable lead, but the game was quite tough. We had a lot of things we had to improve on. And right after that, we established where we wanted to be. We actually targeted the top four of the league. And the second match was Wesley, where we actually won from 1 point. It was Jamaldeen who put a drop goal and got the win for me, and from that moment we knew it's not going to be easy for us. So we worked really hard, because we had Isipathana match coming up. They were the title contenders for that year, because when we played from under 13 with them, they always won, like, you know, all the tournaments at that time. So we practiced really hard that week, and on that week only we found out, like, you know, the potential that I was talking about, and the teamwork, like, you know, the attitude and all that. And finally, when we came onto the field, it was quite a tough match. We won 10 points to 11 at Royal Sports Complex. And after that, we faced, I think, Kingswood. And we won comfortably in Kandy for that in that match. And later, we had the Baby First Leg, which was the match of the season for us, because Trinity had a star-studded lineup. I don't know, like, you know, Murad Ramzin, Sasan Mohammed, Rehan Virakon, all the names they had that year. But coming into Kandy, Bogambara, the atmosphere was really good, and the players' attitude, like I said, it was spot on. So from the moment we came out of the dressing room, I had the feeling that we were going to beat Trinity in Kandy that year. And we came out with the win, 33-25, with 8-point margin for the second leg. And later, the following week, we had St. Anthony's in the middle of the Babby, and it was at Nithavella. We played them, and we won the match comfortably, and we came on to the second leg with, I should say, little attitude, and, like, you know, like I said, we thought we have already won the Bradby. But I think most of the Royalists that year learned, like, the lead is not going to win you the second leg. So we got thrashed by Trinity, and 40 points to 5 actually in our home grounds, which was quite humiliating. But I think we learned our point, and like, you know, we learned our mistakes, and we worked on kept working on, and we still had a chance to win the league. And I told my teammates and my colorsmen, I need to win the league, and that was the only opportunity to recover what we lost from the Bradby. So like again, we came on to practice on Monday, and we focused our minds on one thing, and that was to win the league. So then again, we had St. Peter's, who also had a star-studded lineup. Names I mentioned: Dulaj Pereira, Dhanushka Anjan, Bargo Nanayakkara, Rizwan Medin, and all that. But the team game came into a play, and our pack destroyed the Bamba boys, and we eventually got the win, which was, I think, a huge margin game, 50 points to 41, as I remember. And that gave us like a good momentum going into the final game of the season, which we had to win, which was Science College. We played at Royal Complex, and game was quite tough, but we actually played to our best, and we overcame the opponents, and finally we won the league. I think that was the happiest moment of my rugby career up till now. The players were really happy, coaches were happy. I think the entire Royal Committee was surprised to see that we won, and to be honest, they were behind us, supporting us, and even the coaches were really happy that I could do it with my voice. So unforgettable moments for me in 2011 season, one is Starman Jamal's drop goal at Wesley College's match, which actually won the match for us. And the second one was the winning feeling that we got at Bogambara. I think everyone was surprised to see us beating Trinity with a margin like that. And finally, the home game, the final home game for me, Science College match, and the league decider. We won that, and to know that we have finally won the league is a big relief as a captain.